city council, that's not true.
Chairman Dodd, council, we put together this presentation just because there's some new council members out here. And you probably weren't here when it was approved back in January. So I have Kirsty from AKT Peerless and Chris Douglas from Lots of Engineering. And I just want them to give you an overview of what was approved 2 years ago, and they can explain, you know, what their issues have been.
I got a question. 2 years ago, I know when you came to us, did we ask if you were willing to use our high school co-op?
Chris came in, it's funny that you say that, he just came into our, into the economic suite today. We're really driving that, and actually, the school has a program going on right now, which the mayor and I attended last week.
Yeah.
So we're trying to look at the synergies, while we looked at putting together kind of a bullpen program with Chris to work with the high schools. So, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, we're in dire need of good help.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Okay.
Okay, thank you. So like George said, I'm just gonna give a brief overview, but if you all have more questions, Chris and I would be happy to answer them. So 2 years ago, this project was here before city council. Watson Engineering is the applicant. They've been here in the city for quite some time. They were approved for an IFT, industrial facilities tax abatement, 2 years ago from council. This is made available by Michigan Public Act 198, and the purpose of this incentive is to encourage existing industrial businesses in the state of Michigan to expand, reinvest in their current facilities, expanding, and also to encourage new construction as well, which is what this project is. The IFT abatement for new construction projects abates 50% of all taxes other than the state education tax for up to 12 years. However, city council reviewed the application 2 years ago and approved an 8-year IFT tax abatement for this particular project. As I said, the applicant is Watson Engineering. I'm gonna turn it over to Chris, he can do a much better job.
Yeah, we started the business, or the business was started back by Chuck Watson, who's still involved in the business today. He started it out of his garage in Taylor back in 1981. What started as a one-man shop now has grown to over 400 employees with four locations in two states. We're a manufacturer of sheet and tubular metal fabricated components. What that means is we can just make it, really we can form anything out of metal. Some of our products include exhaust systems, roll cages, brackets, flanges. We make ladders for construction machinery. Just different complex assemblies that are produced for both the prototype and production needs. What sets us apart, go back to the other slide real quick, Kirsty, but what sets us apart is really our extensive capabilities. Whereas most companies, they specialize maybe in one or two types of services, we have multiple capabilities that sets us apart from the competition. For example, we can do laser cutting, we can do CNC machining, tube bending, stampings, robotic welding, charcoal painting, among others. So a lot of our customers consider us like a one-stop shop. We have a long history of participating in community programs. Some of them have been the skilled trades program, the robotics program, the Taylor Foundation for Education Excellence. So we participated in those programs in the past. At one time, you can go to the next slide. At one time, we were nearly 100% automotive, and with one customer making up 85% of our business. Today, we've diversified our customer base and expanded our industries so that we're no longer dependent on any one customer or any one industry. As you can see, you know, we've now, we work for Ford, Caterpillar, GM, Tenneco, Harley-Davidson, We just picked up Mahindra Gens. They're located in Ann Arbor and Troy. We just picked them up a couple years ago. And I was telling George, just in the last month, we picked up John Deere as a new customer. So doing this expansions is very important to us now.
Thanks, Chris. So I included in here some pictures of their current facility if you haven't driven out that way recently. They have several nice buildings out on Rancho Road. They take good care of their property. You can expect the same quality in the new construction that they're actually broke ground last month.
That's our building directly south. It actually is connected to our headquarters. The first picture you saw was our headquarters, which is on adjacent to the property. And this building is directly south. And the reason we wanted to show these photos again, like Kirsty said, is that we take pride in the facilities that we have built. And we wanted to assure council and everybody in this room that the new building is going to look as nice or nicer than these facilities here.
The current project is an investment of over $6 million to redevelop property that they currently own. It's overgrown and had some obsolete buildings on it that they've already started demolition work on. We'll be constructing a 60,000 square foot new facility for light industrial use and hiring an additional at least 75 full-time employees. This is a photo of what the site currently looks like. Again, if you haven't driven out that way, it's overgrown. I believe it's the building on the right that's
building,
been demolished.
The building on the left has been demolished already.
Building on the left has been demolished.
Is this south of what the other building is?
This is southeast. So if you, this is on the, if you look at this view from the Pennsylvania Service Drive or Pennsylvania Avenue, and the Rackos to the west and north is our existing facility.
We are here today because there was a restriction in the agreement that was signed after that the investment had to occur within 2 years,
okay.
And that expired in March, and he broke ground last month due to some of the buildings that we had to. So that is why we are here in front of you tonight, but we wanted to give you a recap since some of you were here sitting on this council 2 years ago. Sorry about that. This is a site plan of where they're going to be. Again, southeast of where their current facility is located, and a rendering of what the building will look like.
So, is this building how would you get to it? From Pennsylvania or off of Racco?
Not from Pennsylvania. Not from Pennsylvania, but right at the corner of Racco and Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania Service Drive that will have access, and then we'll be able to also access it from our other facilities.
So this facility would kind of be behind like the old Top Gun area?
Correct. Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Right. Not on the top work.
The district was approved by council on January 5th, 2016, and then the 8-year exemption certificate was approved on February 2nd of 2016. Again, as I said, the terms of the approval, the agreement that Watson Engineering signed with the City of Taylor 2 years ago stated that all of the investment had to occur within 2 years, so by March 1st of 2018. And that also Watson Engineering had to hire at least 75 full-time equivalent employees within 5 years. So we are here today because they have not been able to meet that first requirement. They did submit site plans in May of 2016, so after they got IFT approval, started that process. In hindsight, should have started that earlier or started our window of investment a year later, because they did break ground in April. They had some delays in getting the site plan approved. It took 2 years going back and forth with the city. And they were also trying to work with the city to find funding for Pennsylvania Service Road. It's in pretty poor repair and needs a lot of investment to make it usable. However, in the last 2 years, they have hired 52 new employees, so they're all crammed into their facility they have. They're anxious to get the new building up and running. 12 of those new hires are Taylor residents. And
we started. Just to elaborate a little bit on what Kirsty's saying is, when we came in January 2016 for the IFT, and this, in hindsight, when I look back, I can kind of say, well, I should have put the dates of the investment. What we did, what I put down was March of 2016 to March of 2018. But in hindsight, what I should have done with the original IFT was put, say, March of 2017 through March of 2019. What I did not take into consideration was just the time frame that it took to do the planning, to do the site the plans, the architectural plan, and so forth. It took a while to get through Wayne County, so again, in hindsight, we just need to push that window of investment out for one extra year.